guys. NCWQ here. And the time is 1:18 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And doing a lunchtime update for the 4.0 to 5.0 and greater earthquakes that have occurred since midnight. So we're going to start off in our first one that is a 4 is Lake Baikal region in Russia. And it is a 4.9 at 10 kilometers in depth. So I've already marked this one on Google Earth. We can see that this one has occurred right in the center of Lake Baikal. Now, I don't know a whole lot about this region at all, so not much I can state about this area. I do know that there are some volcanic areas around there, but that is Lake Baikal. Okay, our next earthquake as we move on. Is a 4.1 Southern Sumatra, Indonesia. And we'll get this one put into our Google Earth here. This does not appear to be happening. Well, it might be. Looks like there might be some houses up in this area. This area is pretty much hilly. But this is where this earthquake has occurred. We have also a unknown type of volcano here, and it's a Quaternary age. It's an andesitic volcano. So that is happening near that area. We move on to our next earthquake. Which is a 4.4 off the coast of Costa Rica, and it was 22 kilometers deep. So we have Costa Rica to one side. We have the convergent fault here. Until we have all of these volcanoes along here, and then we have the drop off here. And then we have the different plates here. This is the Cocos Plate here, so this is right on the outside of the Cocos Plate. The next earthquake was Kapalan Talaud, Indonesia, at a 4.3, 10 kilometers deep. Looks like we have some small underwater seamounts here. If you can see these are seamounts. And then we have two convergent faults as well. So the earthquake is hitting in between the convergent faults here. And this should be a divergent fault. Maybe, yeah, that's a divergent fault.
next earthquake is a 5.0. And it was the Kermadec Islands, New Zealand. And it was 40 kilometers deep. So this is hitting on the outside of the convergent fault. This is near some of the volcanoes. So this is a placement for this earthquake here. Next earthquake is a 4.5 at 194 kilometers deep in Jujuy in Argentina. Hopefully I said that correctly. This appears to be, I'm not going to say it is, this looks like a volcanic field here. If we look close, I mean, we have a stratovolcano here. So I believe that this may be a volcanic field here. Interesting. It's like a line that goes through this. Very interesting. We move on to our next one. Go up here because I noticed there have been two earthquakes in California, a 2.2 and a 2.0. We'll move on to our next page. We had a 4.0 near east coast of Honshu, Japan, and it was 60 kilometers deep. So we go look at this area real quick. And this is off of Honshu, Japan here. Then we have our convergent fault over here. This is a Pacific plate, I believe. Yep. Lots of volcanic areas through here. We'll move on to our next one. Which was a 4.5 Vanuatu. And it was 177 kilometers deep. Looks like a seamount there too. And this is next to Ambrim Volcano. An Ambrim Volcano is a pyroclastic shield volcano. That's what's here. know if there's any views there. It looks like there is, so let's go drop into the volcano. Weehaw! There we go, we get a good idea, glimpse of inside a shield volcano. And that's the small lava lake is there. So we were just in the big lava lake. And now we move on. We had a 4.3 in China. I'm not going to try to pronounce that name. And there's really nothing I can tell you about China. This looks like it's an icy area, but there's nothing I can really tell you because their satellite coverage is not the best. I mean, they show their town names, but most of them are in Chinese. Some of them are in English. They do have volcanoes, but up in this area, and this is Mongolia over here. This is China over here. And they have a volcano down here. That's out of the way, and that's a pyroclastic cones. But this one is up in this area, so don't know much too much about China there. So we're going to move on. Our next earthquake was a 4.4 Xapa, Mexico, and it was 95 kilometers deep. This looks to be in the middle of a field here. This does appear to maybe be some roads, maybe some houses in this area. Can't really tell. There's houses over here. And there's some over here, and here, and here. So there's towns, but there's none like right at that area. So now we move on. Italy had a 0.9. Okay, the next one was 4.0 off the coast of Chiapas, Mexico. So this one should be off land. So we should be traveling from this one. To off the coast here. And that should be, I believe that's a divergent, nope, that's a transform fault, sorry. Yellow is divergent. Convergent. Gotta remember my colors. Transform. So that's a transform fault there. So we'd have one here and one here. Alright, so now we move on to our next one. Go to page 1 here. See if we have any 4s here. We have a 5.5 Fiji region. So let's check out this 5.5. Interesting. So transform and divergent faults are right there. So the other earthquake was right around in here. So we have a bigger one here. Then we've also had one in Vanuatu. So moving on to the next one. .7 Loyalty Islands. So you have the convergent fault there. We have several volcanic islands here. And I would say we have several seamounts here. Move on to the next one. .1 Mindanao, Philippines. Not good view here, but I would assume. Yeah, we have some schools, so we have some buildings here. And we have a volcano down here. See if we have another one. .8 Southeast Indian Ridge is 10 kilometers deep. So that's divergent. transform, and then divergent here too. So we can see where this one is occurring. We have New Zealand over here, Antarctica down here. I believe that's Antarctica, yeah. And then we have our earthquake here. And we have a 4.1 in Aurora, Bolivia. Isn't it funny? It seems like this one just passed around to Bolivia. Because watch this. We're just going to follow around. We're in Bolivia. This area here looks volcanic, so yeah, I would say it is. Because this is pyroclastic shield here, that's Tambo. So this looks like a big, giant volcanic field. Maybe. Sorry, I don't have my placemats for this one. They're on my Google Maps, so I don't have them on there. But this is the divide between Chile and Peru. This yellow line here. You can see these are volcanoes. Moving on to our next one. If I can find where I was at. Okay. Texas had a 2.9 and California just had a 2.7. We recheck again. Coquimbo, Chile just had a 4.1, and this is going to be the last one we're going to do. Sorry guys if my video was boring. I know sometimes I just do these so I can look up quakes for the day, the bigger ones instead of the smaller ones, and see where they hit and sometimes what's at them. You can tell this is a hilly area. I don't see any houses, that's a good thing. So many neat things you can find on Google, though, like the Aztecs. There's an area where you can find the symbols, and you can see it on Google Earth. There's things that you can see written in the sand that you have to look it up, though. There's just all kinds of neat stuff on Google Earth. Hang on one second, I'm going to see if I can find it. I want to show y'all something. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. I'm looking something up so that I can help, so I can show y'all something, but if I can't find it. Okay, I'm gonna show you something I have seen before. We're going to Peru. These are considered the Nazca lines, but I don't know if I can get a better view. And my Google's not showing me a great view. But the Nazca lines are here. And that's what they look like. They're like spiders and stuff, and they're huge. I've looked at them before, but it looks like they're not like showing as good as they used to. I mean, you can see some of the lines here, just not as good as for it to load. Anyway, if you get a chance to look it up, you'll find the Nazca lines, and then you'll find all kinds of interesting stuff. They were like creatures and stuff that were let me see if I can pull it up this way. Okay, we're gonna do it this way. This one here might show better, I don't know. This is the experimental version that they have. But it doesn't seem to be any better than the regular Google Earth. Anyway,
It was worth a try. See, it says Lines de Nazca. There it is. They have like a, looks like a airport runway. And there's another one over here. Anywho, if you look, there's all kinds of other stuff that's there. Alright, you guys, hope y'all have a great day. Me and my sense of humor. Much love, be blessed, and be a blessing.